So how do we integrate this though? I would like to tell you guys a very powerful technique called Wouldn't It Be Nice? Because I think some of you guys may have seen this video before when we do the 1, 2, 3, 4 sine cosine integral. This is how it goes. Wouldn't it be nice if we were looking at the integral of the denominator still the same, so sine x plus cosine x, but how can we actually construct integral that's so much easier than this? Don't say put a zero here, don't do that. But the next easiest one is, of course, if we happen to have the same thing, namely sine x and then plus cosine x, because this is just integrating 1 in the x world, so we just get x. Don't worry about the plus c, that's what we have. Okay, now let's see, what if we have another one, integral of something over sine x plus cosine x? Well, wouldn't it be so nice if the top is precisely the derivative of the bottom? Namely, cosine x, yeah, the derivative of that, and then minus sine x. Aha, excellent, huh? And this right here is equal to the integral of 1 over u in the u world, where u is the bottom. So we just have ln absolute value sine x plus cosine x. Don't worry about the plus c. Is it possible for us to do a linear combination, meaning multiply some number here and some number here and combine them, and then we end up with negative 2 sine x? Yes. If we have a minus here, guess what? Cosine x cancel, and then sine x plus sine x, we get 2. Good, but this is a negative 2 though. So you know what? Let's put a negative right here, and then let's put a negative right here, and then we combine it. But this is not integrating factor yet.